join me here today at Creedy Lakes down in Devon, and I'm here shooting sort of a live feature for you guys on what we call the experiments. The series started about 5 months ago, of which the aim was to compare different aspects in angling, whether that be from sharpened to unsharpened hooks, light to heavy leads, or what sort of hook bait is best. Now, moving 4 months on from the original start date, we're here at the final feature for me, and the one that excites me the most, the one that I've really wanted to do, naturals versus man-made. So what I've done today is I've got fellow gardener and mainline consultant Tony Welch to come down to try and compete with me. One of us will fish a natural approach, one of us will fish a man-made, and then we'll see the results. So without further ado, we'll wait for Tony to arrive, and then we'll do a draw to see who gets what, and then from there, we'll see what's more effective. Right, so Tony's arrived, we're going to do the draw, just to lay out the boundaries of the challenge. The natural baits, where on terms of hook bait, you'll only be able to use natural bait, so it'll have to be sort of real life maggot or corn or hemp or any other way. And the boily fishing, the man-made approach, is literally just purely man-made. So you can't use any artificial baits on the lake anyway because of the rules. So it literally is a case of naturals versus man-made. Quick one, Tone, which one do you want?
Naturals.
Well, I don't want naturals, so you should hopefully let him have the naturals and the boilies.
But didn't you have 50 down here in a day on maggots?
I did about 4 years ago.
I'll have the naturals, mate.
Right, well, I don't really want them because I know someone that was in the tack shop and didn't do very well on them. But anyway, the draw is, so to keep it fair, as you are my guest of honour, in one hand is maggots, in the other hand is boilies. Take your pick.
On that woman.
Ah. You're on the boilies then, mate?
All right.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Let the best man win.
Right on, mate. Cheers. Let's go.
Well, it looks like since I was last here 4 years ago that a few of the fish I was catching at sort of 15, 16 pound of bread, and the very first fish of the day is probably a record breaker for the smallest fish. But at least it's one. It might be a tiny little one, but it's 1-0 to the Maguas. And yeah, hopefully we can get its great, 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 great grandmother, because a day of this wouldn't be too carpy. But yeah, on to the next. The main and predominant way of fishing this sort of venue is a more boilie-based approach. So stuff like fishing sticks or stringers or catapulting your baits over the top. So in order for me to compete with the maggots that they're not used to compared to Tony, I think I'm going to need to do something drastic in order to get a result. So, as Tony mentioned earlier, about 4 years ago I fished a feature on here and really hammered in the maggot. In fact, I think I put about 2 or 3 gallon in and it properly kicked off. I didn't have anything huge, but it went mad. And in order for me to beat Tony in terms of his more boily approach, I think I'm going to have to do the same. So this is what the general plan of attack is. What I'm going to do is I've just got maggot, just normal red maggot, white maggot, and then Hinder's hemp seed. So just that is all the mix that I've got. So it's nothing too complicated at all. And literally, I'm just gonna spot it out. I'm gonna put 20 out first of all. And then from there, I'm gonna keep topping it up. And hopefully, we'll get some action.
Cool.
Well, that's a bit of a result. A real quick bite on the mag. It's just a single with a little bag attached to it, pinged out at the same time as Tony's. And yeah, it's rattled off. Probably more location, more so than bait. Just sort of right place, right time sort of thing. But yeah, a nice little one to start the day. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to continue spotting, get the bait out, and hopefully we can pick up a couple of ones. I'm sure Tony will be hot on my heels soon with the boilie approach, but yeah, a good start nevertheless.
Here you go, first one to the boilie, thankfully, playing catch up with Ricky a little bit, but the boilie's finally worked, a little single hook bait pop up. I'll show you the ring on that one a little bit later on. There we go, low double figure common. We're off the mark.
Here's the rig, guys. To start with, we're using Pro XM main line from Gardner's. Brilliant carp line. It's probably about the best carp line on the market, to be honest, in my opinion. It's super soft, limp, casts well, it knots well, it's abrasive. It's really, really good carp line. Onto the end of that, I've got a CanFlex lead free leader. Not very long, probably 2.5-3 foot there, lead free leader. Down onto a helicopter rig. We've got a target line stop there with a soft bead just nicked onto the top of it, so the swivel can push up and just push that off if need be in case of a crack off. That's down onto an XL buffer bead and a little 2 ounce bolt bomb on the end. Ideal helicopter rig, it's a soft bottom here, so that's going to stick in the silt there and the bait will just flutter down nicely on the top of it. Hookling wise, that's 15 pounds ultra skin in the green. That's down onto a little pop-up presentation on the end of it. It's a size 6 chod hook, covert chod hook, with a little hooker liner over the top, pop-up hooker liner. Just sits the bait perfectly. I've caught lots of fish using this presentation. The hook bait is a little citrus boily, homemade boily, using the mainline Polaris and various flavours.
Right, so just had a fish now, so it's a really good opportunity to run through the rig. So starting with the mainline, it's Gardner Pro in 12-pound line, probably the best mainline I've used, and it's super, super cheap if you want to buy some. Sinks really, really well and super, super strong. So yeah, highly recommended for me. Moving down to the lead-free leader, it's just Camflex lead-free. I think this is £45, but as you can see there, it's really nice and supple. The bit of a difference about the rig in terms of how I set my maggot rigs up is a tad different. So what you've got is just on the leader itself, you've just got two sort of buffer beads, which have put the splice needle through, not the bore, through the plastic. So it gives them a stiff sort of feel on the leader, but then it allows also to come over the top, so it's really safe as well. From that, I've just got a quick quick change sort of swivel with a sort of an anti-tangle sleeve over the top to the rig. And then coming down, I've got an inline lead. Now the reason I've got the inline lead is because just underneath it, I've got a flexi ring swivel, of which I've connected just a bag of maggots. Coming back up a little bit higher, I've got their Trickster heavy braid at the bottom and then trick link there. So it gives the rig a real stiff boom section, which when fishing over maggot and you're getting picked up and done a lot, is essential. And then on the bottom end, I've just got a tiny ball of maggots, and because of obviously the rules of the competition, I have to keep it nice and all natural. So I've got a tiny sliver of cork just a bit to give it a bit of buoyancy. And then the completed rig, literally, all you do is you just hook the hook into the bag at the bottom, like that. Adjust the beads up so it sits flush. And then literally, that's how it goes out. Can't tangle, and the perfect maggot presentation. Right, well, there we go. One on the maggot, one on the boilie, so not a lot in it. I'm currently winning 4-2, this being the biggest at £20. But yeah, the action's heating up. So fingers crossed, with a large portion of the afternoon to go, we can catch a few more. But cheers, guys.
Come on, the boilie!
Well, two fish in the sling, one on the rod. Definitely hot enough on the maggot, but not so much on the boilie. I think this is a small one, to be honest. But it is another fish. It's actually the smallest one in the entire lake. It's a chub. Look at that little tacker, but it's a fish, nevertheless. Can you be honest, please, sir? The water will come from somewhere. And Murder, She Wrote. right with this. It's probably going to be the final fish of the day. Had a good day, Tom?
Yeah, it's been a good day, mate. Good day. Plenty of action.
Plenty of action, which is always good. We think the final scores are about 8-2. We've got a double check. That's 8-2 to the maggots, which at the start of the day, obviously, I wasn't very keen to have the maggots. And the spot that I put the load of maggot in worked initially. And although I've topped it up, it's not really worked as effectively as we thought. So it's mainly been casting bags to singles. And obviously, this is where this little character's come from. And obviously, Tony's done exactly the same, bags to show him fish, but we just found that the maggots seems to be more effective.
Yeah, definitely more on the maggots today. I mean, boilie, just bit fishing, really, just little small PDA bags, crushed up baits, little small wafter hook baits, but definitely the maggots have been more productive today.
I think the venue as well has been fishing particularly difficult, and obviously, by having that natural approach on days like today where it isn't fishing tough, like I know there was three guys yesterday didn't have anything. I think the maggots made me the one, but I think to take from it more than anything is when you go to a venue of your choice, be armed with both. You know, if one's not having it, then you can switch to another and get results. Although this one's not the biggest, it's still definitely another fish that we managed to catch on the maggot. But I think we'll call it a day, mate.
Yeah, mate, well done.
Good contest. And I think, obviously, if Tony had the maggots and I had the boilies, I think the result would have been exactly the same. So, bear that in mind, and thanks very much for watching.